Features of cooperative society. Following are the characteristics of a cooperative society. First, voluntary association. A cooperative society is a voluntary association of people who have the desire of improving their financial condition through joint action. It is a voluntary association of people who have a common interest. For example, a farmer's cooperative society will have all the farmers. Similarly, a producer's cooperative society will have all the producers. A cooperative society is voluntary association of persons who have common interest. A person can join or leave a cooperative society at any time. Nobody is forced to become a member or to continue as a member. Everyone having a common interest are free to join a cooperative society. For example, any farmer is free to join any farming cooperative society. Religious and political neutrality. Anyone can become a member of cooperative society irrespective of his or her religion, caste, creed or political affiliation. The membership of cooperative society is open to all, regardless of caste, religion or gender of the person. Equal voting rights. Cooperative society works on the principle of one man, one vote. Every member has only one vote irrespective of the number of shares held by him or her. This prevents the rich members who hold more shares from dictating the terms. Rich members cannot influence the running of cooperative society as it runs on the principle of one man, one vote. The cooperative society is run in a democratic manner. Separate legal identity. A cooperative society has a separate legal identity of its own. In eyes of law, cooperative society and its members are different from each other. A cooperative society can own a property and enter into contracts in its own name. It can sue or be sued in its own name. A cooperative society can file a case against anyone in its own name. Similarly, someone else can also file a case in name of the cooperative society or against the cooperative society. If any of its members dies or becomes insolvent or becomes insane, the society does not come to an end. The death, insolvency or insanity of any member does not affect the existence of a cooperative society. Service motive. The main aim of cooperative society is to provide service to its members and not to maximize profits. However, during the course of business, the society may earn some profits, but the society's aim is not to maximize the profit. The society doesn't try to maximize the profit. Its main objective is to provide service to its members. Mandatory registration. Registration of a cooperative society is mandatory. It is compulsory to register cooperative society under Cooperative Societies Act. State control. All the cooperative societies are closely regulated by the government. They are closely monitored by the government. This is done to ensure healthy growth of these societies. Distribution of surplus or profit. As mentioned earlier, a cooperative society may make some profit during the course of its business. A part of this profit is distributed among its members. Democratic control. Management and control of cooperative society lies in the hands of managing committee, which is elected by the members themselves. Limited liability. The liability of members of a cooperative society is limited only to the extent of their capital contribution in the society.